Have you ever wanted to move an object with sound? Yeah, me too. Welcome to Impossible Science.
Hey guys, it's Jason Latimer, the world champion of magic. Now, what you just saw with the tuning fork and everything vibrating around, that was a total illusion. Makes for a great party gag, but that doesn't mean it's impossible. In fact, today I'm gonna show you how to actually move an object without touching it, and it uses resonance. Okay, today, your challenge is to move that straw, but you're not allowed to blow on it, you're not allowed to touch it, and you're definitely not allowed to kick the table over. But since we know today is about resonance, if we were to create a sound wave that matches an object's natural frequency, that object would start to move without touching it. Let's give it a shot. No, just totally joking, by the way. Maybe if I practiced the rest of my life, I could get the right pitch, but there's a much faster way. So how's it work? Obviously, it's a magical straw. Just kidding, it's science. Let's talk about resonance. When we strike an object, it vibrates at its natural frequency. If we were to create a sound that matches an object's natural frequency, that object will start to vibrate. This is what's called resonance. As we run our finger around the rim of a wine glass, the friction between our finger and the glass causes the glass to vibrate. If we look closely at that vibrating glass, we will see that the two opposite sides are expanding and contracting at the same time, while the sides 90 degrees to those are doing the exact same movements, just in an opposite pattern. These rapid vibrations in glass cause the air inside to compress and expand in waves. These waves of air pressure create what we know as sound. Your glass is actually sending sound waves to the other glass. And if we get it close to the other glass's natural frequency, it will begin to vibrate through resonance. This vibration in the glass is what's causing the straw to animate and ultimately fall over. Superpower? How about super science? Okay, so the secret behind this is to find an object's natural frequency. But even though these glasses look the same, they sound different. That's because imperfections in the glass, differences in densities and the mold, they're not exactly the same. So, what I'd like to do is find the one with the lowest tone, and we're gonna add water to the opposite one. Because as you add water, you can actually change the pitch of the tone coming out of this glass. Still lower. The more water, the lower the pitch. If you're curious about actually how to even make a glass sing, you need to wet your finger and rub it along the rim. The water level tells you the pitch, but the pressure tells you the volume. Now, wine glasses work the best for this as far as resonance and emitting sound. You can do it with other glasses, but the thicker the glass, the harder it is to get it to vibrate. Let's give it a little bit more water. So, all you have to do is give it a shot. Now, if you're close, it will start to vibrate a little. If you're dead on, it'll vibrate a lot. And there you have it. How to move an object with resonance. Well, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed making an object animate without touching it. And if you enjoyed making the impossible possible, let me know by clicking the like button and subscribing to the channel. And if you subscribe, make sure you turn on those notifications so that you'll know the next time I break something in my house. Until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.